So, after having to spend 9 hours out of my apartment, they're not done. It's only half done. Now, here's the ticket. Is the food in my fridge still any good? Because I don't know how long it was unplugged. So, I don't know. I don't know if it's still good. I got a bunch of food in there, and I can't really afford to have it go off on me. And I also need to cook desperately because there's nothing to eat unless I cook something other than the stuff in the fridge that might be off. And I seriously cannot afford to order in. I just don't have the money for that anymore. After I get my groceries on the next week there, I'm going to be just about broke again already. This is an inconvenience from hell, to say the least. To say the least. And stuff has been moved. Looks like they bumped into the little end table that I got sitting over by the thing there because the loose leaf tea thing is upside down and it's not aligned the same direction. But I do think they wiped down because my wipes were open. My wipes were open and whatnot, and it does have the smell of the disinfectant. So at least they wiped down. The lighting in there is pretty nice. It's all LED strips, and it's really kind of nice. So that's nice. But this whole 2 day thing is just gonna be a complete pain in the ball sack. How am I gonna sleep tonight? Sheesh. Stressed out. It's the smell, actually, that I'm used to sleeping all stressed out because that's my normal state. Has been for years. We'll just put it that way. It's the chemicals that are burning my eyes and stuff. It's gonna be make it hard for me to sleep. I got up at about 4 o'clock in the morning today because I woke up with an intense headache and an intense pain in the neck and an intense pain all down my back, a little miniature fibro flare that was very localized and spread to the rest of my body. And I had that covered in itchy feeling, still do. But that's a reaction to the chemicals in the air, burning my skin. But anyways. It was an intense pain. It was like level 8 pain, and it was like, oh my God, jeez, it sucks. Didn't want to go to the hospital because, that would have been, like I say, I got no money for transport. So my ambulance is covered, but getting back would be unaffordable. Life goes on, then you die. Things are. Did they change? They unplugged my fan for some reason. I don't know why it's unplugged. I have no idea. I have no idea why it's unplugged. It's in the exact same spot, so I don't know why they unplugged it. The plugs don't appear to have been changed, so maybe they changed that one and not the others. I don't know. I got no idea. Computer stuff still, the power bar for the computer is still plugged in, so I got no idea. No clue. No clue at all. I know they're doing the electrical as well, but that kind of looks like a new plug over there. So maybe they did some of the plugs, not all of the plugs. I don't know. 2 days of disruption is gonna be hard because it's I don't like people in here that I don't know, and I don't like people touching stuff, and I don't like any of that. So, especially now, especially with COVID going around, I'm just not a fan of this happening. They moved the garbage that I had sitting on top of the box that I had to throw out, that I didn't throw out, of course, because why would I? I was going out anyway, so why wouldn't I have thrown the box out? Okay. Of course I would have left it here to be in the way. They moved that to get at the breaker box, so something. Obviously the power has been played with a little bit. Stove not installed. The counters are really, there's way more cupboard space. There really is. But the counter space is really cut down. It's gonna suck, actually. I don't know where everything's gonna go. I don't know how I'm gonna get everything stuck in there. I know where to put things. That's the thing. I don't know how I'm gonna have operating space, working space on the counter. Because there's going to be so little of it after I put the microwave on in the corner, and after I put the crock pot on the other side here, I don't know how it's going to how it's going to work out. I just don't. Gonna have to see what happens when I get things back in, which won't be today, obviously, will it? Had to go to the bathroom for a drink of water because the sink's not installed. So yeah, bears. So I don't know if they're going to be here all day tomorrow or what's going to go on. I am seriously not going to go sit downstairs all day like I did yesterday. I'm going to stay in and just hide in my bedroom, I guess. I don't know what I'm going to do, but pain in the balls, pain in the balls. And I'm so itchy. Don't scratch, don't scratch. I'm not supposed to scratch. It's gonna be nice though. It's really pretty. The corner cabinets are a compound door. It opens up on in an L shape here like this. You open it up this way, and then you can pull it and open around the corner. And there's a Lazy Susan. Inside that we can use. There's lots of cupboard space, but counter space is cut down noticeably. So I don't know what's going on there. But I do have actually two plugs, so that's a serious bonus. Because there was only one plug in there, and I had to have one of those things that aren't a good idea to have to plug everything in. So yeah, I can have the little night light and the crock pot plugged in on the one side, and in the corner I can have my microwave plugged in. So that'll be good. That'll be good. Looks like it's gonna rain. That's gonna suck because then I'll have to close the window and it's. The chemicals will kill me in my sleep or something, so Stove doesn't really look that much. Okay, yeah, it is bigger. It's noticeably bigger. I was gonna say it doesn't look that much bigger, but yeah, it does actually. It looks half again as big as my other stove. And it's really tall. It's a really tall stove. Oh good, it's got dials. I don't have to play with anything for the burners anyways. The oven looks like it's computer control thing. That's going to be something to get used to because I've never used a digital stove thingy. And they're telling me the burners are way more efficient. So some of the other people are telling me the burners are really a lot more efficient. So I'm gonna have to watch it when I'm cooking on it. I'm gonna have to watch it quite a lot when I'm cooking on it for that reason. Yepers. Till I get used to it. Yeah, because you used to have to have a crank right the hell up to boil water on the old stoves. So this is gonna be nice to have a nice new thing. Yep, there it is. 524 kilowatt hours. Energy guide. Blah 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 blah. Anywho, had a great coffee. We sat out there for a long time. I was out there for 4.5 hours till I came home. So that was hard on my body, but I made it. Fortunately, for some reason, my legs didn't cramp up nearly as much as they normally do. So, and that mini flare that I was having in the middle of the night seemed to have pissed off by about 9 o'clock in the morning, so that was good. That was all good there. Yeah, there's no sleeping though. No getting back to sleep, that's for sure. And I'll have to set my alarm again for tomorrow so that I don't get woken up by them showing up. Oh, geez, yeah. Scandal and gossip. Here we go. I guess the one guy was complained about because he was standing in his underwear watching them install his sink and stuff. Which is freaky to me that they would not tell him, "Hey, dude, go put some damn clothing on, He's been warned about running around in his underwear like that in front of people before, so this will be his third warning. He might get booted because there's a three strike policy in most places. So yeah, he might get booted. Somebody pooped himself while I was downstairs. They didn't quite make it to the bathroom, so that was a little bit disconcerting that he did that. But yeah, I've been caught nearly doing it a few times because I just got home in time a few times because of my bowel troubles and due to fibromyalgia. I just sometimes have to go right now, and it's not common, but yeah, most of the time I can hold it, but sometimes it's like no, right now. So I've had a few close calls, so I can sympathize with the guy. I really can. Hey Google, what's the temperature?
The temperature in Moose Jaw right now is 14 degrees.
14 degrees Celsius. Yeah. You betcha. Other than knocking my tea over and moving my tea ball, I don't think they did anything else. Probably just knocked the little thing there for a loop while I don't think they knocked anything on the floor. Doesn't look like it. Just knocked the thing for a loop, that's all. Anyways. God, I'm gonna be so itchy all night now. It's just killing me already. Silicon caulking. I have a chemical sensitivity to that, and I have a chemical sensitivity to the wipes, which is a necessary evil because you got to use them, right? You got to wipe down your groceries and stuff when you get them and whatnot. So, Oh well, good thing I'm stuffed from that all-day breakfast that I had out at Smitty's. Because I don't know if that leftover pizza is any good in there. It should be though, because unless they open the fridge door or anything like that, it should be still good. Stuff will keep in the fridge after the power goes out for a good 6 hours, so 6, 8 hours, so it should be okay. It should be okay. And your freezer is actually good for about 12 hours. So 12 to 24 hours, they say, depending on how efficient your fridge is at keeping cold. So, yeah, and the fridge itself 6 to 8 hours, something like that. So it should be okay. They should be okay. I got a little bit of bean mix left in there and the leftover pizza. So that'll be tomorrow's food, I guess, because I won't be able to cook tonight to have food tomorrow. Yeah, everything else is in exactly the same spot, so that's good. They could have dusted while they were in here, you know. Grabbed a duster and got at her, right? I got the weirdest thing in my toilet, by the way. So this is really long vlog, but I got the weirdest thing in my toilet. There is this gray stuff appearing in the toilet, and I don't know where it's coming from because it's not in the water. Because if it was in the water, it would should be showing up cloudy when I got a drink of water, but it doesn't. It's nice and clear. It's just my toilet. Seems to be just my toilet too. So I'll clean it out and with the brush real good, and then the next day it'll be covered in this gray stuff under the water line, and I have no idea where it's coming from. I don't know what it is. I talked to the maintenance guy while I was sitting downstairs, and he took a look at it, and everything seems to be okay physically with the toilet. There's no molds hanging around in it in the tank or anything, and he dumped some industrial cleaner that's been sitting in there all day, so hopefully that'll kill whatever it is. I have no idea. I've never seen anything like that before, ever. Not ever. So, yeah. Anywho, yeah, there goes my eyes. They're starting to burn. This is gonna suck. Oh, well. Had to be done sometime, though. What is that thing on the... Oh, there's a light on the roof, too. There's a big LED box light on the roof that I didn't notice in there. Yeah. But that's nice and bright. The under-counter lighting is nice, and the little range hood over the stove where it's going to be installed is nice. Yeah, I gotta go play with that now, see how bright it is. Yippers, yippers. It's going to be nice when it's done, but it's a huge inconvenience to me. It just is. Yeah, anyways, y'all have a fabulous day and keep smiling.